All right, guys, let's be honest. Fortnite's a little wacky, but, you know, it's pretty fun, right? I mean, we wouldn't be here talking if it wasn't. You feel me? So, I gotta tell you about this. Did you guys know that China has its own exclusive, slightly weirder version of Fortnite? I didn't know either. So today, we're gonna be showing you guys 10 of the craziest changes in China's version of Fortnite. You guys gotta stick around. All right, guys, so at number one, China's got totally different default skins that are exclusive only to the Chinese version of Fortnite. Okay, so if you take a look at them, it's pretty simple why they did it, as the player models look more like Chinese players. So as far as we know, Fortnite China has at least two different default female skins, Rio and Evelyn. You probably recognize both because they brought Rio over in Chapter 2, and Evelyn's a limited time unlock in the item shop as the Brilliant Striker skin. Come on, Epic, come on. You guys gotta hook us up too. Bring on Evelyn back over here. Her design is amazing. Plus, Rio was actually already in the game before Chapter 2, technically, since a couple of exclusive skins use her as a base model like Rook and Fable. And it looks like they have a slightly edited version of the Renegade Recruit skin from Chapter 1. They've even made him look more grown up and even more serious. Although apparently these skins are just literally used for just marketing, right? Like, they're in promotional photos and adverts, and you can even see them in the lobby. But when you load in, it's just the same defaults that we have. I mean, I guess they have to do something with all those Jonesy skins. All right, guys, so at number two, Fortnite China's is actually changed more than just the default skins. Some outfits are changed entirely, and others have literally just been removed from the game altogether. And get this, guys, like, most of it has to do with spooky skeletons. See, most games released in China try to remove any mentions of skeletons in general. And it's become kind of infamous, with loads of people saying this is because of Chinese government or Chinese culture. But that isn't exactly true, guys. See, there are actually no official Chinese laws against putting skeletons or violence in your video games. What's happening is that the Chinese censorship laws for gamers are just super vague. So it's actually Wii Games, the people in charge of publishing these games in China, who are censoring them. They're just being extra careful so that they don't have to remove stuff later. So skins like Skull Trooper and Skull Ranger are just flat out not in the game. And you know, whenever Skull Trooper comes back to the shop, instead Fortnite China gets Hollow Head. And whenever Skull Ranger Ramirez is supposed to show up in the store, instead of the Chinese version, gets Bunny Moon Armstrong. Other skins are just changed to remove that kind of stuff. Like Mystique's Skull Bike Bling is just a gold sphere, and Shadow's Mask has just got rid of the skull print entirely now. But Blackheart's face is just entirely removed. I kind of like that version more, to be honest. He looks kind of terrifying. All right, number three is actually a pretty welcome change. Fortnite China has no microtransactions, guys. That's right, which means you cannot spend money inside the game.
Everything, Battle Pass, literally everything Chinese, the challenges, a locker, which have nothing. Here's the item shop and stuff like that. Sadly, you can't use support a creator on Chinese servers, but look.
Because of a law passed in November 2019, there's actually a monthly legal limit on how much you can spend on DLC inside a game, and it works on a sliding scale. So the older you get, the more you can spend every month on stuff like V-Bucks. It's still not a lot, but it does go up. So because of that, you just can't buy them, right? Like, the tab to buy them is literally not in the game. So to fix that, there are so many different ways to earn V-Bucks instead. Like, for example, there's in-game challenges, and they're a lot easier than they might sound, actually. Like, you can just get a couple of hundred just for hiding in a haystack. And if you reach level 30, okay, you just get the battle pass for free. At one point, you can even fill out a survey on the Tencent Games website and get 1,000 V-Bucks in the game for free. I wouldn't mind doing that either, to be real. For those V-Bucks, I would do whatever you want, Tim Sweeney. Come on, call me. All right, here we go. Moving on. At number four, we got a big one here, guys. Okay, so as Fortnite China actually has different victory conditions from our version of the game. See, in our version, okay, the only way to win is by being the last player standing, right? So you have to actually defeat everybody else to get your victory. And obviously that has its own satisfied feeling, but the Chinese version is pretty cool as well, guys. Like, if you survive the match for 20 minutes, you automatically get the victory royale. Wow. I know what you're thinking right now. Like, that sounds like it's just gonna make everybody just camp, right? But that's really not true, and let me explain why. They actually added another change that fixes this problem as well. If you get loads of kills in Fortnite China, that gives you an option. You can keep playing, or you can just get the choice to leave. You're still getting a victory out if you leave, but you don't have to play through the rest. And this means both people who play aggressive and campy benefit from this as well. And this obviously isn't anything like the Fortnite we know, and it really changes how it plays a lot, but this could be really fun as like a training mode. Maybe we could do over here. And also, it could be much easier to get people into the game if there was a mode like this. All right, guys, number five is the reason why. Okay, you see, China Fortnite doesn't use arena mode. Never has and probably never will. And it's because of a Chinese law that puts a curfew on how much people under the age of 18 can play games. It is illegal to play games between 10 p.m. and 8 a.m. And you're only allowed to play for 90 minutes a day or 3 hours on the weekend. So that's why you win in 20 minutes. You gotta make every second count. And to be fair, video game addiction is a serious problem in China and all over the world. So even though China passed this law in November 2019, the company Tencent was already putting time restrictions in other games like Arena of Valor as early as 2017. So Fortnite China actually tells you when you've been playing for over 3 hours, but it doesn't stop there, guys. It actually reduces all rewards by 50% if you keep playing, you know, stuff like Battle Pass XP, and it freezes all of your progress and your challenges too. It even tells you to go exercise a little bit, and if you keep playing, eventually you get nothing at all. To us, it may seem a little bit extreme. I get it, but they do kind of have a point here. Remember, guys, we do have to take our health seriously. So arena mode wouldn't make any sense in China at all. Like, games would go on way too long, especially casually. Chinese tournaments even have to use different rule set to get around this, giving you points for kills as well as where you play. So it's the person with the most points who wins, not just whoever's the last one standing. All right, guys, number six is sort of similar. I know people have said in the past it's got no limited time modes, but it actually does. They're just on a different schedule to ours, and it kind of doesn't seem like they're set in any pattern to them.
Side by side comparison, we don't have the Marvel Knockout mode, we don't have Party Royale, we do have Marvel Takeover, we have solos, we don't have duos, although in some regions.
That means at times when we have nothing, they could have modes like 50v50 or the floor is lava. Those modes are where, you know, I've had some of the most fun playing Fortnite, so honestly, it would be kind of cool if there was a way just to switch between the two regions. Well, until they do, we've got number seven for you guys instead. All right, shout out to iFireMonkey for finding this one, and almost no one is talking about it. Fortnite China has freaking trading cards. Now, before you guys get excited to add to your binder, these aren't physical ones, but an entirely digital collection instead. You know, it looks like Wii Games has a client for all their games in China, and you can actually get drops for trading cards across them. I mean, it's not like a thing in the actual game, but your account updates with them the more you play. So there's different tiers for rare cards that go from common to legendary, and there's even limited times ones too. Since Wii Games manage Chinese Fortnite, it's of course, you know, one of the games that you can get cards for. They're not just for looking pretty though, all right? Like, there's also a mode called Card Battles that actually lets you use your deck. You can play against an opponent, and the point of the game is to find pairs of as many cards as possible. It's like one of those memory-based card mini games that you find in other games. Yeah. It's not exactly dueling with a Blue Eyes or Charizard, but it's a lot cooler than nothing. All right, guys, number eight is another weird one because the storm works completely different, guys. All right, if you take a look at the UI, specifically the health bar, there's actually a third extra bar. This is your signal bar. It's essentially a health bar just for whenever you're in the storm. I'll explain why it's called that in a minute. Anytime you're in the storm, it ticks down. It only heals whenever you're in the white circle, and even then, it refills really slow. When it runs out, that's it. You're dead.
It's only storm health, so it only gets taken off from storm damage, but you can't heal it, and if it hits zero, then you die. Ooh. Wait, what?
And this is just my own guess, but I think the reason is because of the time limit China has on younger players. Since you automatically die, when the bar runs out, you have no reason to not keep moving and make sure you stay in that white ring. And because it's just a meter, it's just, you know, way more dangerous than just losing some health. Camping isn't a legit strategy in Fortnite China because of this meter. I mean, how many times have we seen someone make that classic play? They run out of the storm, right, for just a little bit. They flank someone and then remove them from the game with a shotgun to the head. This pretty much solves that problem, guys. Makes the game way more aggressive and really makes games finish way quicker, although it gets rid of a lot of strategy too. Number 9 is the game backstory. If you take a look at the Chinese website, there is an entirely different lore reason for why the Battle Royale is even happening in the first place. See, in the Chinese version, it's actually set in the future. And in the universe, their environment is dying and aliens are planning to invade because this planet is now weak. So instead of just backing down, people are selecting warriors to go fight and defend humanity against the aliens instead. All right, we gotta be real here, okay? That's a little pretty dark for a game that looks this colorful and kind of sounds a little bit more like Halo than I'm comfortable with. All right, so anyways, to test these warriors and make sure they're ready, scientists build a virtual island for training. And the warriors project themselves in it by using some unexplained hologram technology. And this is pretty much one big loophole to get around the violence of the game. Whenever you die, it's actually just your hologram's battery running out. I mean, it's really, really cool. It's also why there's a signal meter instead of a storm. All right, guys, at number 10 is a fact, Fortnite China has its own sick cosmetics. It's got two unique back blings that we're almost definitely never gonna get here. But they both look really, really good. And there's this penguin that sits on your back and this really clean looking black and gold shield thing too. It's really dope. The reason we're probably never going to see them is because they're based off of two Chinese companies. The penguin is based off parent company Tencent's QQ logo, which is of course also a penguin. And the design on this shield is a modified version of Wii Games logo. Earning them is a hassle too. They use a medal system, and to enter, you need to have played at least 20 hours in total. So this lets you refer a friend, and then they have to play for 10 hours. If you do this, this unlocks one medal. You need 9 to just unlock one of the two. It's probably pretty rare, even on Chinese servers. All right, guys, so what did you guys think of our top 10? Do you want any of these changes to come over here? Seriously, like I wouldn't mind those free V-Bucks, just saying. Let us know your thoughts down below, my friends. Once again, this is your motivation guy, Keith Allen. And man, I wanna connect with you guys soon. Connect with me on my Instagram. We got so much amazing content coming out also on this channel, man. So we'll see you soon. Peace.